Advent is for all of us a time of renewal. It's such a special time in the church's year. It's a time for us to be renewed, so that what Jesus began at Christmas will reach its intended goal within each one of us. We've made a special effort to come here this evening for this celebration of Mass. You and I are here this evening because we want to be more closely united with Jesus, particularly in the greatest chapter of the salvation history, in his death and in his resurrection. We are here this evening because we want to be converted, because we want to be changed, because we want to be transformed into his image. The mandate is very clear, and Father Ian and myself will say the words over each one of you as we place ashes on your head in a moment. The mandate that we are given for this season is quite clear. Repent and believe the gospel. Repent and believe the gospel. How we obey the command, how we keep this mandate, will very much depend on how we keep Lent and how we commit to observing this most holy season. And so as we come to the moment to come forward to receive the ashes, we pray, Lord Jesus, you have called me into the desert of Lent to be with you. Help me to fix my eyes on you and on the Father. Purify me, Lord, and give me the strength to stay close to you for these 40 days.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly ask God our Father that he be pleased to bless with the abundance of his grace these ashes which we will put on our heads in penitence. O God, who are moved by acts of humility and respond with forgiveness to works of penance, lend your merciful ear to our prayers, and in your kindness pour out the grace of your blessing on your servants who are marked with these ashes, that as they follow the Lenten observances, they may be worthy to come with minds made pure to celebrate the paschal mystery of your Son. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now I invite you to come forward to receive the ashes. Let's stand and pray. And place our prayers and petitions before the Lord. We pray for the church throughout the world, that we may gather together during these days and walk these days together with the Lord. Lord, in your mercy. Let us pray for our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, to the Lord who chose him to be bishop, may sustain him in health and in courage to proclaim the message of the gospel to the church and the world. Lord, in your mercy. Let's pray for all those who are in any kind of need at this particular time, particularly those who are sick, those disadvantaged in any way, that the Lord may be with them. Lord, in your mercy. Let's, in a moment of quietness, now place our own prayers and intercessions before God, our Father. And we ask the intercession of our Blessed Lady as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. God our Father, we ask you to listen to all our prayers, those we have spoken out loud and those deep down in the silence of our own hearts, and we ask you to grant them all through Christ our Lord.
During the preparation of the gifts, a special offertory collection will be taken for a charitable cause. Thank you.
Thank you.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God. We solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent. We entreat you, O Lord, that through works of penance and charity, we may turn away from harmful pleasures and cleansed from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.